It was the War of 1812. The British Navy was blockading the Boston Harbor, not allowing American ships in or out. The USS Chesapeake, led by Captain James Lawrence, immediately left the harbor and engaged the British ship Shannon. Outmanned and outgunned, the Chesapeake was disabled, and Captain Lawrence was mortally wounded. As his men began to carry him below the deck, he gave one final command to his officers. Don't give up the ship. Fight her till she sinks. The Chesapeake was lost, but the war was won, and the captain's message lives on. His friend and fellow officer, Oliver Perry, ordered that the phrase, "Don't give up the ship," be used as a battle ensign that the U.S. Navy still uses today. The Navy phrase has resonated with me and my family. There are a great many forces out there that are telling us that Utah values are old and outdated and that they need to change. We constantly hear that our population is growing and that we need to adapt. Some are using this as an argument for the growth of government. The Constitution, which I believe was inspired by God, is being overlooked and neglected. Utah has experienced substantial growth over the last couple of years and will continue to do so. This is due to our business-friendly environment. Not only are we business-friendly, but we have strong values and tight communities. There are some that are saying that the government should be the solution to our growing pains, that we could regulate businesses to deal with our growth. I believe that the growth we've experienced over the last couple of years is because of our limited government and our limited regulation. I worry that if we allow government to grow, that we could stifle the progress we've made. My message to Utah is, don't give up the ship.